Hey fellow tennis nerds, welcome to another edition of Tennis Nerd Talks. It's been a while since I did this format with me talking over some footage and images, and I wanted to give you an update of how I'm doing and what I'm reviewing and so on. So I'm still injured. My wrist and forearm still hurts when I hit my forehand, especially on my one-handed backhand. It's fine, and my elbow is sore every morning when I wake up. I'm doing all kinds of exercises. I'm resting. I'm using anti-inflammatory gel. I'm going to massages, going to the physio regularly, but so far nothing has really helped to relieve the pain, especially the one on my wrist. The tennis elbow is not as bad, but the wrist is an issue, and whether it's due to stiff forearm muscles or something else, I don't really know. I'm not sure either what's caused this injury, but my change from Eastern to semi-Western grip, along with playtesting countless of rackets and strings, have not helped, of course. That's why I would recommend you to find an arm-friendly setup and stick to that one. Also, make sure your technique is smooth and does not create any problems, create any discomfort when you're swinging your racket and impacting the ball. I'm currently testing a few different rackets and strings. One of them is the Prokenex KI Q Plus Tour Pro 315, which is a thin beam racket with an open string pattern. As you might know, Prokenex is the leader in the industry when it comes to arm friendliness, thanks to their kinetic system with moving sand kind of inside the frame. Really nice and soft racket with a thin beam and an open string pattern. I'm also waiting for a Vocal C10 Pro as a classic racket review, along with a Prince Graphite Oversight. When it comes to strings, I'm still testing a few different string project strings. I will talk about more about that soon, and a new head experimental tour, and RS New York, which is a multi-filament. I'm testing that in a hybrid with RS Lyon and RS Octagon. I can't play as often as I want due to my injury. I still try to hit lightly once a week or so to check my progress. It might be stupid to do this, better maybe to just rest. And I have tried to rest, but it's not really helping at the moment. And I'm definitely struggling not to play at all. It's really tough to stay away from the court when the weather is still good. I will see what I can do in consultation with my physio and to see if it can improve my health and I can still go and hit at least once in a while on the tennis court. So what I can show today is some light point play with my head liquid metal radical tour in the Tennis Nerd paint job, and it's strung with String Project Gold, a multifilament from String Project, and it's strung at 24 kilos. So as I'm looking for a really arm-friendly setup, I think this string would be nice to try in a full bed. And I really want to be able to play a confident game with good control, and this setup actually seems to work really well. This multifilament is very soft, but still plays control with minimal movement. Similar to Wilson's Sensation, but more rough to the touch, feels a bit more solid. So it's almost like a somewhere in between a polyester string and a multifilament string. And it's really soft on my arm. And I'm quite happy with it so far. I'm gonna try it in more rackets as well. So String Project strings such as Magic, the red one, and Gold, they're really soft, so I can really recommend you to give them a try. A softer alternative that still provides good control. As you might know, I get a lot of questions about rackets and strings, to give advice, what tension to use, what racket would fit, what's the difference between that racket and this racket, and to be quite frank, I can't keep up with them all. Simply not humanly possible as a one-man brand to do this. I try as hard as I can, so I would really appreciate that if you want string, racket, and customization advice, please consider paying for this service in the Tennis Nerd shop. I set up a product called Racket and String Advice. You fill in a form and then you will get a detailed email with help, and you can also ask counter questions. This is a way to support Tennis Nerd, but also for you to get a really detailed information and suggestions on string and racket and customization in an email, instead of it becoming a situation where I try to reply and give advice on all these YouTube comments and Instagram questions I get. You can of course also become a Tennis Nerd patron, where you get unique content quite frequently every week now, trying to bump up the tempo there. You can also make a donation to Tennis Nerd. All these things help to keep Tennis Nerd going. It's quite time consuming, and I can't really keep going at this rate. So I hope you are healthy, and I hope you're playing a lot of tennis. I wish you all the best. Take care, and talk soon.